Greetings. Peace, family. I hope you can hear me. So first of all, I want to start off with a song. First of all, I do not own the rights to the song. It's a song by Left Eye. I'm not going to play the full song, but it's a pretty deep song. So hopefully you can hear it. If you kind of listen to the words a little bit, we're going to get it started with that to bring up the energy here. So let's get ready to do it. Again, I do not own the rights to this song. I do not own the rights to this song. So this is Lisa Left Eye Lopez, Living Life. Hey, Miss Martina, how you doing? Little late night reading. I don't drink that often, but I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little tipsy tonight. Well, not tipsy, but a nice little buzz. Can you hear it? I hope you guys can hear it. A great one going. But anyway, this one's called Lisa, and it's off of Left Eye. Lisa Left Eye Lopez is Left Eye Legacy. So this CD is called Legacy, but I just wanted to share that with y'all. All right, so now time to get down to the nitty gritty of things. So what I'm gonna do is do a 3-card reading. So first things first, this actually is called Couple. This here is, if you will, a protective mineral. You could actually burn it with charcoal for protection. It's kind of like sage on steroids, if you will. So this will be pile number one with the couple. Pile number two is going to be High John Root, John the Conqueror. That's other protection. These are also things that if you're looking into setting up an ancestor altar to represent your ancestors and give homage and respect to your ancestors, these are some of the things that you could actually add to the ancestor altar to help give it some energy. Of course, I'm quite sure most of you know, but also sage. You could burn this around the house. You always want to fan it. You don't want to blow it. You want to make sure that you actually fan the sage to kind of spread that positive energy. And then also by blowing it, it's like blowing away your, not necessarily luck, but like blowing away the spiritual cleansing, if you will. So you always want to make sure to fan it. If you can get a big feather, like a condor feather or an eagle feather or a hawk feather, that's even better because you could actually fan it around the house. And again, like I said, with the couple, we also have the couple incense. That's great to, you know, cleanse your house spiritually. And then also we have Agua de Ruda. So Agua de Ruda, you actually have to order this online. I think it may be backwards facing you guys, so I'm going to hold it up for a little bit. But it's called Agua de Ruda. You have to order it online. And this is very good for spiritual cleansing as well. And a lot of you probably are already actually aware of the Florida water. So Florida water, you could actually, we purchase it at Walmart out here all the time. You could also order it on Amazon or order it online. This is great for cleansing. Like when you dust, wiping down your counters with it. You could put it on your third eye. I do that all the time. It smells amazing. Again, it's called Florida water. Put it on your third eye, you know, put it on your neck. And it's great to like help lift your energy, if you will. And another great thing you could do is actually put your Florida water in a spray bottle. So that way you can spray it around the house, on the rugs, on the couch, things of that sort. So we're going to get to the reading. So like I said, so we're going to kind of focus and concentrate a little bit. And you're going to decide if you want to pick the couple the high John Root, or this is actually, I don't know if you're familiar with Papa Legba, but he's one of the Loao Haitian deities that can actually assist you with connecting with your ancestors. You know what I mean? And that and so another thing, before we actually get into the reading, ancestor altars. See, that's another thing that our indigenous melanated people need to start doing, is connecting with our ancestors. If you'll notice, a lot of the people that are successful, they represent their ancestors. They have their ancestors on their money. They have their ancestors. They celebrate their ancestors. And that's the problem with melanated kings and queens. We don't celebrate our ancestors. You know, our loved ones that passed away, we don't honor them. Not to say every ancestor, because I know that. And so we have ancestors, and then we have our loved ones that are dearly departed that have crossed over. You know what I mean? More recently. And then we have our ancestors that are like generations back. And a lot of us don't honor our ancestors. And that's a reason why a lot of us indigenous people of color are struggling, to be honest with y'all. So that's why I feel in my heart that like my ancestors are letting me know that we need to start representing our ancestors, start setting up ancestor altars, and start making sure that we show love for our ancestors. You know, because they literally shed their blood for us. It's some of them that did not make it that are still in the middle of the ocean right now as we speak. And we don't take the time to say, you know, thank you for you know, getting us to where we are. And so the first step with setting up an ancestor altar is, of course, the altar itself. I don't care if all you have is a literal shoebox. That's fine, to be honest with you. You get you a regular white candle. The 99-cent store is handy, because I know it could be a struggle nowadays, especially with everything that's going on. So you could always run up to the 99-cent only store or Dollar Tree or something like that and, you know, check out their candles. You know what I mean? They get a white candle. Get a nice little glass, you know, maybe like a champagne-looking glass or something along the lines of that, and put some water in there, bottled water, you know. I always use bottled water. I don't know why. I wouldn't use sink water for my ancestors. If you have a loved one that passed away, they love coffee, you know, get them coffee. It's various things you can do. Definitely fresh flowers if you have them. If not, if you don't have fresh flowers, you can do things like fresh tobacco, herbs. There are several things. And then a very important thing that a lot of people don't talk about is, if you know that it's an ancestor or a loved one that passed away and they are of a very dark energy, you know what I mean? That's not somebody you want to honor. That's not somebody you want to be dealing with at your altar, because that's what they're going to bring. Whatever energy they had before they left this plane, that's the energy they're going to bring. You could, of course, send prayers and love and light their way, that they can be elevated to a higher plane, so that way they can, you know, work with you and assist you one day. But you have to be very careful as to say, you know, when you set up your altar, okay, I want to work with ancestors that have good intentions at heart, that have love at heart, you know what I mean, that care for me and my good, you know. So again, the main four key ingredients I would say again is a nice glass of water, and you want to just change it out frequently, not let it set. You want to get, like I said, rosemary, thyme. Those are great herbs to use. Just, you know, you could put it on a plate. They love fruits. You know, you could use fresh fruits, you know, grapefruits, bananas, things of that sort. And just make sure that, of course, that you change it out. Normally what I do, depending on, so when you start working with your ancestors, they'll actually guide you. So sometimes they may instruct me to leave the fruit by a tree, a beautiful tree. Sometimes they may instruct me to throw it in the trash. So you just have to pay attention. Once you set up your altar, you'll be very much more connected with your ancestors, and they'll be able to guide you in different methods to take. So again, water, fruit, if you can, fresh roses. Every now and then you may actually be cooking something and you feel one of your ancestors like, hey, let me get some of that. You know what I mean? So pay attention because they'll actually communicate with you as to what they need. And that helps them because it's like an energy transfer. You give to them, they give to you. You know what I mean? And you work back and forth. And the key ingredient, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against spiritual wickedness in high places. Y'all not ready for the truth. See, they give us the Bible in the way that they want to give it to us and don't teach us how to use it properly because we will be powerful. When I tell you we're powerful, we are powerful, melanated beings that can do some amazing things in life and they not ready. We not ready. And that's why they try to keep us in the dark with so much negativity. That's all you see on the news. That's all you see, just negativity. You know what I mean? Pressing against us to tear us down. And when you keep somebody that's supposed to be elevated to a higher level on a lower level by what you feed them, it's not allowing them to wake up spiritually. Once we start to wake up spiritually, hey, how are you doing, Mr. Vevic Monday? I do apologize if I mispronounce your name. How are you doing today, sir? So you have to keep your energy up. You have to. And I'm speaking to myself with a lot of this. A lot of this I'm talking to myself because, oh my goodness, with what's going on, you guys already know everything that's going on. If you don't pay attention to the good in life, you're going to help to co-create the darkness that's going on in life. You know, so once you realize the power that you have within just your DNA, it's a wrap. There's no one that's going to be able to stop you on any of your endeavors. And don't ever let anybody tell you that you can't be successful in any of your endeavors. Don't ever let anybody tell you that, because the people that tell you you're going to fail are the ones that failed at their endeavors. And just because they fail doesn't mean that you're going to fail. So that's directly from the ancestors and from the heart. Like, it's so many people that are trying to give up. Don't. Because most of the time when you decide that you're going to give up, you don't even know the finish line was right there. It's right there. And the moment you give up, you gave up and missed the finish line. It kind of reminds me of a story. There was a man that actually had, I don't know exactly the proper terminology for it, but basically there's like a string of gold, and it was in the 1800s. And he was digging for this gold and doing very good at it. So he hit a point in the string where the string of gold was gone. And so he dug a little deeper, nothing, dug a little deeper, nothing, dug a little deeper, nothing. And right when he stopped and decided to sell that farm, somebody else came and bought it out. Do you know that they dug about a foot and a half and there was a string of gold right there? So long story short, we need to learn not to give up so soon. Because right when we feel our breaking point, there's amazing, miraculous things at the other end of that foot of dirt, which is the gold at the end, you know? And I, that's what I feel like the energy is saying tonight, man. There's so many of y'all that want to give up. Don't. Because you're an amazing soul. And if you know here that it will be here, then it's going to be here. And those of you that are awake know just what I'm referring to. So we're going to get into this reading. I kind of got off kilter there. So again, we have the copal for those that are just coming in. Again, that's the copal. So we have pile number one. There's three cards in each of these piles. And then we have the high John roots. That's some great protection. If you could get a hold of some high John root, walk around with it in your pocket. It's awesome. Hey, wifey, I see you watching. I love you too. Alrighty. And so last but not least, we have Papa Legba's key. About Papa Legba, do not listen to American Horror Story. That's all I gotta say, because since I've been walking with Papa Legba, my life has been amazing. Amazing. He's actually came to me in various forms. Do your research. Like, do your research on the Haitian deities. Just in general, because it's deep. It's deep. So many of us have been misguided and misdirected and told that things are dark that are not dark. Because those things that are dark will get us where we need to be in the long run. So, again, we have Copal for the first pile. That's Copal. We have Hijan Root for the second pile. And we have Papa Legba's Key for the third pile. So I'm going to give you a second to kind of think and meditate a little bit to see exactly, you know, which pile that you want to pick. If you guys want to go on and throw the number of the pile up there on the screen, that's fine. Once you decide the pile, think of your question. You don't have to place the question in the comments. You could actually just, you know, just in general, think of the question in your head that you have. Okay? So, is anybody still here with me? I see one person, but I'm not sure who it is. So if you want to put the number of the pile again on the screen so we could go on and get to the reading. This is actually the Hoodoo Tarot deck that I'll be reading from. Again, the Hoodoo Tarot deck. Oh, Papa Legba. I knew he had something to say to you. I really did. I felt that. I knew in my heart and soul that you were going to pick that one. I knew it. All right, so we have for Miss Martina, we're going to do Miss Martina's reading first. I do see there's another person in there. Again, we're doing a pick a card reading. The first one we have is the Copal. The second one we have is Hijan Root. And the third one we have is Papa Legba's Key, the opener of the gates and the closer of the gates. All right. So I see it's a second person there. If you're interested in getting in on the pick a card reading, you could again put either Copal, that's spelled C-O-P-A-L, Hijan Root. So if you just want to put Hi, I-G-H, or Key for Papa Legba. Okay. So the first one that we have is going to be for Miss Martina in the building. How you doing? And so she actually picked Papa Legba's Key. I know it's kind of beat up, but it walks with me everywhere. Even, and Papa Legba's day is actually Monday. But I walk with him every day, like every day, you know what I mean? And that's his sigil. I don't know if you could see it or if it's a little blurry. But it's Papa, and his last name is, I mean, his name, Legba. So it'll be L-E-G-B-A, also known as Elegua. Elegua. But, all right, so here we go. Let's get into the reading. So the first card, ironically, like we said, Papa Legba, older debonair gentleman. All right. And sometimes he may actually come in the form of a homeless person. He's not always going to come in the form of an Inglesian king. You know what I mean? He's not always going to be black. He may come in the form of a older white man, an older white lady. You never know. You know, angels come in all forms. But this right here will be the Father of Knives. Hopefully you can see it good. Okay. That's the first one. Again, the one that we picked, that Miss Martina picked, is actually Papa Legba, okay? And so, again, that's the Father of Knives, the Father of Knives. So we're going to get the Father of Knives pulled up for you in this reading to see exactly what it has to say. I've actually been doing tarot reading now for maybe a couple of months. I've been walking with spirit all my life. You know what I mean? So let's get, again, the Father of Knives pulled up for you. And just bear with me. There are a lot of cards here, so. Oh, right to it. So, Father of Knives. So, the meaning for the Father of Knives. Do you have your question in hand? So, long, make sure that you got your question at hand. You do not have to ask the question in the thread. So, Miss Martina, do you have your question? Again, you do not have to answer it in the thread. All right. So, again, the first card we have is the Father of Knives. Father of Knives. For those that want to know, this is the Hoodoo Tarot deck. The Hoodoo Tarot deck, and it's with Miss Tayana Lee McClear, I believe. McQuiller. All right. So, for the very first card, the Father of Knives is the quintessential dominant male. On the positive side, he is assertive, intellectual, ethical, analytical, mature, and is a leader. On the negative side, he is cruel, opinionated, vicious, abusive, stoic, tyrannical, and stubborn. In a reading, if he is represented a literal person with these qualities, then he represents these attributes. So, of course, it's obvious that your very first question is pertaining to someone. And these cards are very clear. They're very blunt with a lot of things that they say here. So, as you see very clearly, you know, it's somebody that's tyrannical. It's somebody that's abusive. It's somebody that's stubborn. You know, that right there is very clear. It can't be no more clear than that. That's somebody that... It's time to snip the cord. Spirit is blunt. So in a lot of these readings, I'm going to be extremely blunt. And because, I mean, sometimes you have to be clear. But that's saying straight, clearly, it's time to snip the cord. The Father of Knives is a quintessential dominant male. On the positive side, again, he is assertive, intellectual, ethical, analytical, and mature. A just leader. But on the negative side, he's cruel, opinionated, vicious, abusive, and stoic. And it sounds to me like when it comes to other people that this person deals with, they're more upbeat, loving, and kind. But then when it comes to you directly, it's more cold and cruel. So, I mean, that, like I said, the Father of Knives. And hopefully this is resonating with you. Let me know if it's resonating with you. And so we'll get to the next one, which is actually the Mother of Coins. So this is the Mother, again, the Mother of Coins. So let's go on and get to the Mother of Coins for you. Boom. Right to it. Mother of Coins. So, the Mother of Coins is all about investing time and energy to improve one's quality of life. On the positive side, she is an animal lover, in tune with nature, caring, practical, resourceful, body positive, freely, expresses warmth, and keeps her word. On the negative side, she is self-absorbed, materialistic, and a shopaholic or a gold digger. In a reading, she does not represent the literal person. So we're going to stop there because honestly, I feel like it's the negative side. It doesn't apply. I really do. Like, I feel like the ancestors are stopping me right there. So we'll just go with the Mother of Coins is all about investing time and energy to improve one's quality of life. On the positive side, she is an animal lover and in tune with nature, caring, practical, resourceful, body positive, freely expresses warmth and keeps her word. So, it's definitely speaking in the manner of, we'll go back, of course, to the the Father of Knives. So, it's like, you're doing what you need to do on your end pertaining to the relationship, but you don't feel like they're pulling their weight on their end pertaining to this person, which, of course, is the Father of Knives. That you're referring to in that question. So, like I said, these cards are very blunt. Very blunt. I did a reading for myself the first time I got them. And that's funny because the very first time I actually got these cards, I did a reading for myself. And I'm very meticulous about keeping my, like, books and things in order. And so what I did is I put this book here and stacked it neatly with the cards on top of it. The very next morning, when I came into the living room, I swear to God, it felt like an energy, like there was a party in here the night before. And all the cards was just like in a messy pile. And nobody messed with them. So these are some very powerful cards. I just had to share that little story there. So with the Mother of Coins, again, honestly, just keep doing what you're doing on your end. You're doing the right thing. You're doing the right thing. Keep doing what you're doing, and everything's going to start to fall into place the way it needs to. And I feel that very, very strongly that it's going to fall into place the way it needs to. And so that's the Mother of Coins and, of course, the Father of Knives for the very first pile. And so then the next one we have is actually the Nine of Baskets. Okay? Hopefully you can see it there. It's the Nine of Baskets. I'm glad that resonates with you. I see you said it's spot on. Awesome, awesome. So the Nine of Baskets. Let's get that pulled up for you here for the Nine of Baskets. Just bear with me one moment. Sorry about that. Getting it pulled up. So here we go. So for the Nine of Baskets. So what I was just saying on the card before, that is going to work out. Right? So this one is actually saying positive dreams fulfilled. Plenty of art, appreciation, wishes that come true. Sensuality, rewards, hitting the jackpot, happiness. Pampering the finer things in life, financial security, prosperity, attaining your heart's desires, gratitude, and making it. Key word, gratitude. That's standing out to me so strong right now. We got to learn to walk in the attitude of gratitude. And again, I'm talking to myself because even me, myself, has the tendency to, sometimes focus on the negative. But we got to learn to focus on a positive, because for every negative thing that's in our life, there are amazing, miraculous, wonderful, positive things in our life. That something simple as you're not on the side of the road with a sign. Something simple as you have a bed to go get into. You have a refrigerator to go in and get food. Like if we... Gratitude, that's standing out so strong to me. We need to learn to be grateful for the smaller blessings so the bigger blessings can come into our life and our being. And once we're grateful for the smaller things, we're untouchable. We're unstoppable. We're unstoppable. So we just have to definitely keep pushing forward in gratitude. Keep doing what you are doing. And ancestor altar. I really feel that strongly. There's no coincidence that you picked Papa. Because he wants to work with you. And you need to set up an ancestor altar. Set up an ancestor altar. You are a very, very intuitive person. You're a very, very spiritually connected person. You've experienced many, many things that are paranormal, if you will. But don't be fearful of it. Don't be fearful of it because you have some amazing things to bring to this earth. You know what I mean? You have some amazing, amazing seeds that you are raising that are going to make some major changes. And you gotta keep pushing. You got to keep pushing. And you know what I mean? Anything that's negative in your life and not building you in a positive manner, it's time to let it go. It's time to let it go. Because you have a lot to bring. And you know you do. And you don't feel honored in a lot of ways. You know, you don't feel honored by any means. And I actually feel very strongly here. Very, very strongly that I need to do the Hijan route for you. The Hijan pile. I really feel very strongly that this is like a conclusion of the first pile with Papa. You know, that's what I refer to him as Papa. You know, I don't know if you're familiar with Dr. Sebi, Miss Martina. Are you familiar with Dr. Sebi? I know it's probably a delay in the video, but just let me know, are you familiar with Dr. Sebi? That, I mean, that's Papa Legba's energy. Like, Dr. Sebi definitely walked with Papa Legba's energy. And that's definitely Papa Legba's energy. And I feel strong. Oh, man. Like, he wants to work with you. He wants to work with you. You need to really set up an ancestor altar in somewhere that's away from, you know, people if possible. A lot of people say, oh, you shouldn't set up your ancestor altar in your room. But that is honestly the best place, is to set it up in your room. Because, and also you could kind of speak with your ancestors to find out. Because it may be some ancestors that really would prefer you don't set it up in the room. You know, but with me personally, my ancestors, we're good. We're good within the room. Sometimes you may actually have, you know, a lot of people living with you or where it's a lot of people coming in and out. So you want to have it more private. But I feel really, you really need to, you need to set up an ancestor altar. And my ancestors say it all the time. I don't care if it's a shoebox with water and a cracker on a plate. And that's all you have, you know, some sort of honor. And just, you know, I thank you, ancestors, for protecting me. I thank you, ancestors, for the many, you know, sacrifices that you've given to me. We're taught to worship something that's not legit, that's not real, and wonder why we're struggling. And the moment you start honoring your ancestors, doors will open. Things are going to start happening that will amaze you, you know. And I really feel whenever something's repetitious for me in spirit, is your ancestors want to walk with you. They want to talk with you. They want to guide you. But you're going to have to set up an ancestor altar and honor them. And even if it's not just Miss Martina that I'm speaking with, I feel that it's so many people that were raised religiously and not spiritually. So they fear certain things. And these things that we're taught to fear are the things that will help us be successful as melanated beings. And, whoo, ancestor speech. The energy is real, man. The energy is real right now. But like I said, Miss Martina, I feel that the ancestors would like me to read one more pile for you, which is Hijan root. Okay, so for those of you that's just stepping in, hello, greetings. I see there's a couple more people that came in. I'm doing a pick a card reading. So we have Kopo for the first pile. We have High John Root for the second pile. And we have Papa, for those familiar with Papa, Papa Legba, for the third pile. So if anybody else wants to get in on this reading, you can go on and just let me know which pile that you would like me to read. We already went over this pile for Miss Martina. And now we're going to go into the High John Root pile. I really feel strongly that this is going to be a continued reading of what we already went over. So are you ready, Miss Martina? Oh, there's going to be some travel. There is going to be some travel. And I feel it's good travel, too. Mm-hmm. All right, so for the High John Root we have here, the very, very first card we have is going to be the Railroad Bill. Travel. Travel. Moving forward. Clearing things. Wherever you see train tracks, there's a clear path. It's about to be, woo, some things opening for you, girl. You are not ready. That energy. I know it was a reason for me to read tonight because I'm not going to lie, I'm tired. But I felt in my spirit and soul that I need to read tonight. I really did. So if anybody else that is watching, please notify me with the 1111 if you would like a reading. I'll do a 3-card reading for you as well because I'm really feeling that there are some people that need to hear messages here. No charge, none of that. You know, we're just doing it all love. It's all love. Just all love. Just, you know, honor the ancestors. That's all I ask, man. We need to start honoring our ancestors. We don't, and that's the problem, man. They're weak. You know, they need to be honored. They need to be fed. That's why they're not able to do what they need to do for us. You know, oh, Robin, hey, my old track buddy. I don't even know if you remember me, but you and your brother Ryan, we used to run track together in Ganesha High School. I miss y'all, man. The twinsy twinsies. So, but back to that. So the card for Miss Martina. I got you, Miss Robin. We're going to read you after Miss Martina. So just to let you know, Miss Robin, we actually have 3 card piles. So we have Kapu, which is protection. Kapu. We have High John Root, which is protection. Okay, so that's the second pile. And then we have Papa Legba's Key, which is the third pile. Okay, and so many people have a misconception about Papa Legba. Anything pertaining to us melanated people, they always make it dark because they know that we are some powerful-ass beings. Powerful-ass beings. And they don't want us to be successful in our endeavors. But it's time we start waking up, man. It's time we start waking up. For real, for real. All right, so back to the railroad. So the railroad, and this is awfully ironic because you actually have 2 MasterCards in this pile that we pulled. So the railroad, again, clearing. There's some openings coming through. There might actually be some of you. And so, Ms. Robin, also think of a question. You don't have to say the question out loud or anything like that. You could just think of it in your head. So that way, when we pull up your reading, you know, your ancestors, because whenever we do a reading, we're working with our ancestors, you know, and that's loved ones that have passed away. An uncle is coming through for you, Miss Robin. Woo, his energy is strong, strong, strong. He had a beautiful, beautiful smile. He had a beautiful smile. Like, that's the main thing I could feel. Oh, man, I got chills right now. Ooh, we gonna talk, Miss Robin. We are gonna talk. All right, so... So we have Railroad Bill. Again, in a reading, that's very rare to have 2 dominant cards. You know what I mean? Because there's so many cards there. So with the Railroad, we have clearing. You know, there's a major clearing coming. Major clearing coming your way. So with the Railroad, just bear with me one moment here. So the meaning for the Railroad. Again, this is a dominant card. So with the dominant cards, they actually have a lot more information pertaining to your question. And again, this is leading Miss Martina into that same question that you had for that first pile, before we actually got out that High John route there for you. So, when railroad bill turns up, you are being encouraged to increase your efforts to ensure victory. It's a reminder of the characteristics that are required to win. Confidence, determination, discipline, persistence, and assertiveness. Now is the time to adopt a take no prisoners attitude. So don't let nobody stomp on you no more. It's time to start kicking ass and not letting your ass get kicked. And like I said, I'm very, very blunt when I do readings. And start kicking ass and stop letting your ass get kicked. And it might be actually some people that, because like right now I'm currently reading for Miss Martina, but it might be some people that this is resonating with. It might be some things that you're going through. Start kicking ass and stop. What is that they say on, oh man, what is that movie? They Live. He said, I'm here to kick ass and chew bubble gum, and I'm all out of bubble gum. It's time to spit that damn bubble gum out. It's time to spit the damn bubble gum out. And I don't know what else to do but be very blunt with my readings, and that's why I always let you know up front. But it's time. It's time for you to step up to the plate because you are so powerful and you are allowing people to like defeat you and stomp you down. And it's time to say, damn that. You want your ass kicked or you want to kick ass? You know? So now, so if you receive a railroad bill in a reading, consider the following. If you do not plan to win the game, then why the hell are you playing? Oh my goodness, what was I just speaking on? Wow. Success is the best revenge. So those that feel they're being doubted or being belittled or ridiculed, don't even let it bother you. Don't let it get to you. You just be successful, and not even for the other person. You be successful for you. That's the problem with society. We all focus on so much other things. We focus on everybody else. The latest celebrity gossip. The latest this. The latest that. And if we were to put that same energy into ourselves, do you know the magnificent, magical beings that we can be? But that's a whole nother video there. Get rid of any people or situations that are distracting you from your mission now. Spirit talking. Ancestors moving. What is... I knew, didn't I tell you, Miss Martina, that I felt that you needed to hear that High John pile as well? Oh my goodness. And to let you guys know, I believe on Facebook they got a limited amount of time to do the video. So if for any reason this video cuts off, I will start another video right away. So just keep an eye out for that. And again, so far we've done one reading. We have Miss Robin that's going to be next. So we have one more slot for one more reading. So whoever hits me with 1111... then I got you. I got you on a reading. So the next person hit me with 1111. If you want a reading, let me know and I got you. So it's my way or the highway. You hear that? It's my way or the highway. And anytime, Miss Martina, anytime that a deck repeats itself, that's some power. Okay. I'm not sure if that's Mr. or Miss. I see Marlon Brown. So is it Marlon? Yeah, Marlon Brown. Okay, I got you, Marlon Brown. So that'd be my third reading. But so it's my way or the highway. And on that note, I'm kind of feeling very strongly that the people that you should compromise with, you're not compromising with. And the trifling ass motherfuckers, excuse my French, like I said, I'm very blunt, that you should not be compromising with, you're compromising with. So it's time to cut that cord. It's time. It's time to sever the cord. I feel like it's a grandmother coming through for you. And she, I don't know if it's a grandmother. It's like a very strong grandmother energy, but I almost feel like it's your grandmother's sister. So it'll be like a great auntie, if you will. And she didn't play no shit. And she's saying, cut the damn cord. Like I said, these readings are going to be very, very blunt. I don't know any other way to be but blunt. When you deal with your ancestors and your spirit, some of them that come through, they're like, look it, damn it, I've been telling your ass, and you've been knowing, but you're not listening. Cut the damn cord. Cut the cord. Cut the cord. So what competition? There is no competition for you. You have to know the magnificent being that you are. You have to know it. We only compete against ourselves. And there's so much that we have to bring to this world. You have things that you could bring to this world that can't nobody else bring to this world. And once you start walking with your ancestors, that's what will give you that opportunity to see what it is you need to bring. What do you love to do? Like, what do you absolutely love to do? What can you see yourself doing and getting paid for? And you wouldn't even care if you got paid or not. That's what you're meant to do. That's what you're meant to do. And, you know, and it's just, it's time for us to wake up, man. It's time for us to wake the hell up. Wake up. Bottom line. That's what I'm feeling like. Wake up. Wake up, man. We're so sleep. It's a sleep zombie-like society that would rather listen to what somebody else tells you that life is than get out there and experience it yourself. You know? Stop running to Google and start running to the library. You know? Start running to the library. It's so much ways that we could uplift ourselves that's beneficial to us. So, know thyself. Propel thyself. It's just falling in line. I just said that. We need to know who we are, and we need to know how powerful we are. It's called self-esteem for a reason. Stop waiting for others to cheer you up. I'm so done with these ancestors. I love my ancestors, man. I love them. You know, I just said that we need to, oh, wow. It's just literally lining up exactly back to back to back to back to back to back. You know, back to back. And we have so much to bring to this world, man. We have so much to bring. You know? So domination happens. I'm allergic to humble pie, so you can have it. You know, a lot of times what it's saying is quite the opposite, and it's like we need to start to humble ourselves. Okay, so Miss Martina said, I've always said I wanted to work with ex-felons, but now that I am, it feels like the worst career move. So, what makes you happy? You know, what makes you absolutely happy? What can you see yourself doing the rest of your life and not get paid for it, and you will be the happiest deer running through the forest? That's what you're meant to do. What do you think about? What is it like? Me, for me, like, I work doing customer service. But I love hip hop. I love doing beats. I love rapping. I love poetry. I love teaching. You know what I mean? That's what I would love to do. But, you know, of course you have to work. You don't work, you don't eat. But once you start to work with your ancestors, that's when doors start to open so you could actually do what you love and make excellent money at it. Make excellent money at it, but you have to see it. Like, you have to see it. Write it down. If you have a desire, a heart's desire, like, say, for example, oh, you want to be a race car driver. All right? If you're not taking your ass to watch races, then how are you going to even begin to start being a race car driver? So that's the things. Whatever you feel you want to do, even if you don't have the means at the moment to start doing what you want to do, you could just write down, you know, what you love to do. Write down what you love to do as if it's already done. Even pertaining to things like a house that you're looking for, a car that you're looking for, love life. you know, you have to be specific as possible and write it down as if it's already done and say, okay, thank you, that is done, ancestors, and leave it and don't worry about it no more. And watch how things take off for you. Watch, that's just a part of it. And when you have that ancestor altar set up, that helps a lot. Because you can literally go up to that altar and place your hands on your ancestor altar and, you know, thank you, ancestors. I just want to talk to you. I just want to commune with you. I just want to thank you. You know what I mean? Man, the energy here is, I hope you can feel it. Anybody that's listening, you, the energy, you can feel it. I promise you. Anybody that's awake, half-ass awake, you know, it's so much that they're doing to keep us down. And I say it all the time. We are the X-Men they speak of. We are the Marvel comic characters they speak of. And by them keeping us down in our energy level, they're not allowing our DNA to activate and elevate to the magnificent, magical motherfuckers that we are. And not, excuse my French, I mean what I say and say what I mean. Like, you are a power... Man, oh man, we take our melanin for granted, and that's all I'm gonna say about that. But I'm gonna try to stick to the reading. But it's like when spirit gets to moving, it's a powerful thing. It's a powerful thing. So where there's a will, there's a way. Yeah, it's an ego thing. This reading is talking to me as well. I was just talking to my wife about that today. We got to get our ego under control. And I'm speaking to myself, like I said. Whenever, this is how you know the ego's moving. If it makes you not feel good, that's the ego. You know, when you start feeling that good energy and you're feeling uplifted and your spirits are high, even if it's something as simple as a song, and all of a sudden, those negative thoughts come in like, I don't know why you happy. You, oh man, that light bill's due, you know. We got to learn to shut that shit down, man. We got to learn to shut it down. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against spiritual wickedness in high places. You know, they don't teach us the truth in the Bible. If we would have knew the truth in the Bible and we were to move with that as we're supposed to and not be following these spells that they teach us, be blessed. Oh, have a blessed life. Be less. Replace that with blissed. Wordplay of the day. Replace that with blissed. Oh man, I am so sorry, Miss Martina. I know you like, if you don't get back to this dang on reading. So you can do it. You can do it and you will do it, period. And that's the very first thing that I started this reading off with. You can do it and you will do it, and don't let nobody tell you different. Get the hell away from the news. Get the hell away from that fake ass news, man. You know what I mean? All these movements. Y'all not ready for this truth, man. Y'all not ready for this truth. And so, last but not least, Miss Martina, we have the Four of Knives. Again, that's the Four of Knives. As you see, he's kicking back and relaxing. That's telling you need to kick back and relax. Rest. Rest. Rest, rest, rest. That's another thing, man. We do not get rest. And I don't mean rest like, oh, I'm sleeping, good night. I mean on a spiritual level. On a spiritual level, we don't rest our spirit. We're tired. Our souls are weary. You know what I mean? Especially when you walk with your ancestors, you can literally feel what they went through. And we complain so much. We complain, but gratitude is much more powerful. I don't care if all you have is a damn cracker and some water. You better be grateful for that cracker and every bit of salt on that damn cracker. And you watch how the universe gonna bring you a whole nother pack of crackers and some more water. I promise you. And that's my word, is my bond. I'm speaking from experience. I was raised Christian. I was raised in the church. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Okay? And, oh, man. I've had my ancestor altar up now for about maybe 4 or 5 months. and I've had more happen positively within that 4 or 5 months than a lifetime. And that's my word. That's my word. So let's get to this Four of Knives here. Because we got to get to Miss Robin next. And then we will get to Mr. Marlon Brown after Miss Robin. So I forgot about y'all. So here we go. Here we go. Here we go. So it's for the Four of Knives. And again, this deck is actually the Hoodoo Tarot deck. And it, I know it's backwards to you, but it's a Miss Tayana Lee McClear. She's actually from North Carolina. If you want to get that, you could actually get it on Amazon. And this is a very powerful, sassy deck. This is a very powerful deck. For those of you that didn't catch the story, I actually, the very first time I did a reading for myself, I work right where I'm at right now. I actually, you know, put the cards nice and neat when I got done with the reading and set my book down and stacked the cards nice and neat on the book, a little bit neater than that. And when I got up in the morning, I could feel the energy as if someone was in here partying and having a good old time. And the cards were just a mess all over the place, forwards, backwards, and nobody touched them. That's the, like, this deck is no joke. It's no joke. And like I said, it's very blunt and very straightforward. And when I work with, like, my ancestors are very blunt. Your ancestors are very blunt and straightforward. You know what I mean? So, woo, I just love it. I love it. I love, 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 love. And I wish I would have learned how powerful it is working with your ancestors a long time ago. A long time ago. And so, just bear with me. We are trying to get the Four of Knives here. Like I said, this is a very, a very, very, very decent card stack. So there's a lot of information. So we have, oh, awesome. So the Four of Knives. Again, the Four of Knives is saying relax, set back, you know, relax. Like, start paying attention. I really feel that ancestors have been communicating with you, and not just Miss Martina, but other people on here, your ancestors have been communicating with you. The way we were raised is to be caught up, like caught up in false reality, for lack of a better term. And it's just time we start waking up. It's time, it's really time we start waking up. And so for the Four of Knives, positive, a well-deserved rest. What did I just say? That's the first thing I said. You need to rest. A well-deserved rest, introversion, prayer, recentering, relief from stress, finding sanctuary, contemplation, solitude, peace, quiet, recovery, quiet preparation, meditation, and getting a grip. I hope that resonated with you, Miss Martina. I really do, because I, like I said, I usually, when somebody does a pick a card reading, we'll do one pile. But if I feel that the ancestors are communicating, you know, that there needs to be more said, then I'll definitely, you know, express that. But rest. That's the very last thing it's saying. You need to rest. You need to rest. You know, get rest. Please get rest. And like I said, that might not just only be applying to Miss Martina. It might be somebody else that's listening that this is resonating with. Get rest. We need to find a way to rest. We live in a society where everybody is so busy doing for everybody else that we don't take the time for ourselves. You know, that's why we as indigenous melanated people have so many health issues. Not just from not resting, but also working with our ancestors, man. That's all I got to say. I don't care if you put up a nice little candle. Make sure you have the 7-day glass candles. I use white. You know, you could commune with your ancestors and say, hey, what color do you like? You might have an ancestor that might want pink. So you can't always go according to what, don't, you know, I always say, don't believe what I say. Research for yourself. You know, but me personally, I'll use, like I said, a white candle. If I'm doing some money work, then I may use a green candle. If I'm working with my papa, then I'll use a red candle. If you're trying to do some clearing, then black candle, you know? And get our ancestor altars up, man. If you look at the people that are most successful, as I said earlier, they honor their ancestors. They have their ancestors on their money. They're celebrating their ancestors with the holidays, you know, and we don't celebrate our ancestor holidays, our ancestral holidays. Before, so don't get it twisted. Not all black folks in America are from Africa as slavery and as slaves. So we're going to get, that's a whole nother video there. You know what I mean? But what was our religion? What was our spiritual belief before all the madness happened? That's what we need to get back to our roots and start working with our roots. And just, you know, working with our roots. All right, so, okay, so next we have, one moment here. Let me make sure I do this in the proper order. Okay, so, all right, so Miss Robin, are you still with me? Miss Robin, are you still with me? I think the video is a little bit delayed, so I'll just give you a moment here. Great, great, great. So, now, which pile did you want here? Okay, so whenever somebody picks a pile, what I do is I change out the cards for them. Okay, so now we have, and it was three cards off the bat. So we have the couple, which is protection, of course. Couple. It's couple resonance spelled C-O-P-A-L. Is different botanicas or places you could get this at. You could actually burn it on charcoal. And it's like, if you're familiar with sage, it's like sage on steroids. It clears out negative energy. So that's the very first card we have is the couple. Then we have high John root for the second set of cards. Okay. And then last but not least, we have Papa Legba. So the second set of cards we have already read. So again, I'm going to replace those with some new ones for you here. And again, three card pull. So think of your question for me, Ms. Robin. And you don't have to place it on here live or anything like that. You can just think of the question. And then let me know if you want the pile one, couple, pile two, high John root, or do you want pile three, Papa Legba. So I'll give you a minute to, like, it's no rush. Just kind of meditate and feel what pile resonates with you. Think of the question that you have. Once you know what question you have, you could go on and hit me with 1111 when you're ready. There's no rush. Take your time. And I'll go on and get my little vape in. Okay. Oh, you're quick. You know. I know you're a Johnson. Yeah, it must be a Johnson thing. No. Alrighty. And so we're going with pile number three. And that's awfully ironic because Papa Legba is the one that actually has me doing this reading tonight. I was a little bit tired from working all day, but I really feel that I should do this. I really feel very, very strongly that I should do this. So, and do you have your question, Miss Robin? Okay, good, good, good. So, pile number three is what Miss Robin picked. And then up next, we have Mr. Let me make sure I get the name right. Marlon Brown. Are you still here, Mr. Marlon Brown? If you want, you can go on and start thinking of your question and also the pile that you want to pick, if you're still here. Alrighty, so Miss Robin, the very first card we actually have. Again, for those that are just stepping in, I'm reading out of the Hoodoo Tarot deck. It's a very, very powerful, very beautiful, brilliantly melanated deck. Okay? So the very first one we have here is, and that's a Bishop C.H. Mason. And just to let you all know, these are actually real people with a real history. So I'm just reading the basic nitty gritty of the cards, but they actually have a history with each of these cards on here. And these are actually real people. And again, that's Bishop Mason. And I feel like your question is like a multifaceted question. That's the energy I'm getting. It's like one question, but I feel that even though you're thinking the one question, you have other things that are kind of bothering you along with that. But let's get into it. So we have, again, a Bishop C.H. Mason. Let's get him pulled up. And by the way, that's a dominant card. The dominant cards are the ones that are like the lead cards or the head of the pack, if you will, in the arcane. So an elder card, if you will. That's also another name that it goes by. So let's look up Bishop Mason here. Alrighty. So just to kind of give you a little bit of backstory about Bishop Mason. Now, this card combines Bishop Mason's iconic photo with the interpretation of what his spiritual baptism looked like. He said this about the moment the Holy Spirit visited him. So when he had gotten me straight on my feet, there came a light which enveloped my entire being above the brightness of this. You're waking up. You're waking up. Your third eye is opening. Your third eye is opening. That's obviously why you're here. Because normally you wouldn't even really be up this late. You would normally, I feel like very strongly in my heart that you would normally be asleep about this time. And you don't really even do social media like that either. But you just had this inclination that you should be here. Your third eye is opening. There's some lives around you that you can change. There's some doubt, some self-doubt that I feel is being cleared. That there's being cleared. There's more clarity starting to come into your life. You're starting to see things more clearly. You've been asking for clarity. And I just really feel that the clarity that you've been asking for is going to start manifesting. Start paying attention. Start paying attention. It's, ooh, man. I knew this was going to be a powerful reading tonight. I knew. So, above brightness and sun. When I opened my mouth to say glory, the flame touched my tongue, which ran down me. My language changed, and no word could I speak in my own tongue. Oh, I was filled with the glory of the Lord. My soul was then satisfied. You're waking up. This just verified what I said. You've been seeing some things that kind of have been spooking you out a little bit lately. Don't be spooked out by it. Walk in your authority. Start walking in your authority. Start walking in your authority. I almost feel like you've had a lot of paranormal experiences since you were young. Unexplainable things, miracles, miraculous things in your life. And you've been the creator of them. And you're just now starting to realize your power, and you're just now starting to come into your power. In regards to that, you're waking up. Your third eye is opening. I don't know if you've been maybe having pressure in your head, headaches lately. That's a great thing. Your third eye is opening. Your third eye is definitely opening. I promise you that. Wow. Wow. The energy I get in the end. You've been having a lot of ancestors around you too. It was a recent situation that happened that you know you were protected. I won't really get into it, because when your ancestors speak, it's certain things that you may want to expose, certain things you don't. So in respect, they're saying it's a situation that happened, that it was something miraculous that got you out of that situation. And you know, just what I'm referring to. I don't know if it was maybe about within the last year. I don't know if it's health wise, but it's a situation that happened that people were like, that is no way. This is a miracle. This is a miracle. And you walk in miracles. You constantly have, when you want to give up, that's when you're the strongest. That's when you're the strongest. You have some, wow. And your uncle is, I feel like he didn't live the greatest life. He wasn't really happy. Feels like that he could have did better by the family. But your uncle is definitely around. He's around. And I don't know why. I feel like he had a jerry curl. You know what that is. We from Pomona, girl. Don't play. But I almost feel like he had a jerry curl. And I don't know if he wear a members only jacket all the time. But your uncle is coming through very strong. Mustache. And if it wasn't a jerry curl, I don't know if he had good hair. People would kind of compare him to DeBarge. To a DeBarge. And he may not actually even be a blood uncle, but he was raised to, you were raised around him to where, oh, that's my uncle. Like, I feel like that's not my blood, but that's my uncle. And it's something, he died fast and it was tragic and nobody expected it. Nobody expected, I don't know if it was a car accident or something to do with the car. But I feel like he's definitely around you. He's definitely been watching over you. Definitely. Like, it's very strong. It's just the uncle energy. I don't know. Hopefully it's resonating with you. But he's coming through very strong. Very strong. All right. So for this card, for again, that is anybody that's just stepping in, that's Bishop Mason. Okay? Bishop Mason. So the meaning, when you receive Bishop C.H. Mason in a reading, you are being asked to humble yourself and trust the teachers, guides, and elders of your community. I just was saying that you need to work with your ancestors. I just was saying that. Like, it's kind of a fear there because of the way you were raised. But you know your power. You know. You already know. You've already seen it. You've already seen things happen that just by thought. Something that anybody else would have said, this will never happen for you. And just by your thoughts, your mere thoughts, knowing that it was going to happen for you, it happened. And it lined up in a way so smoothly that you knew that you created it. I don't know exactly what it is that I'm referring to, but it's coming through very clearly. It's several things that you've created, and you know just what I'm referring to. Alrighty, so this is especially true if authorities... Wait, let me make sure I have it correct. So this is no easy task, an age when no one wants to be told what to do, and authorities of all types are subjects of deep suspicion or outright hatred. This is especially true if said authorities are representative of so-called organized religions. While there is excellent reason to be skeptical of anyone attempting to assert, I believe is pronounced USURP, our agency, we should not allow paranoia to become too crystallized in our consciousness. Saying the same thing that I just said. You got this. You got this, man. It's terrible that us melanated, magnificent beings we're our biggest enemy. We doubt ourselves so much. We doubt ourselves so much when we know what we're capable of. And it's wow. This is amazing. And again, like I said, I'm talking to myself as well. Like I'm definitely, it's like the ancestors speaking to me as well. So while there is excellent reason to be skeptical of anyone attempting to absurd our agency, we should not allow paranoia to become so crystallized in our consciousness that we end up throwing the baby out with the bathwater. And that's referring to so much deception in the spiritual community amongst our people, our melanated people. I don't know how to say it much more clear than that. We're taught to worship something that is non-existent. And we're taught that working with our ancestors and our altars are satanic. But yet the very same people that tell us that we're satanic and to worship someone that's not even non-existent, not bless me, not one day, we're taught to worship and drink the blood and eat the flesh, but we're satanic. But like I said, that's a whole nother video. Alrighty, and so while there is excellent reason to be skeptical of anyone attempt, sorry, if I read that one more time, you can slap me, all right? So Bishop C.H. Mason represents the conventional wisdom of any and all societal institutions, be they universities, places of worship, or corporations. Basically, this includes any place which rules, guidelines, rites, rituals that must be adhered in order to consider officially a member of a community. The bishop also represents unspoken rules, as they are often just as important. For example, a person attending a heavy metal concert in a well-fitted khaki suit, a button-down shirt, and a popped collar with loafers would almost instantly be identified as being an outsider. It shouldn't matter if the person in preppy clothes knows the lyrics to every song the band performs. So it's critical to understand that no matter how free-spirited an individual is at the concert, consider themselves to be a what-the-hell reaction to the preppy dresser, in indicative of still being part of the system. The bishop asks that you recognize the importance of group cohesion, corporation, submission, temperance, and conservatism regarding the matter at hand. This is most likely not the best time to do you. So the question that you're referring to, I feel like you need to be more open-minded about the situation. I feel like you really need to be more open-minded about the situation. Kind of think outside the box, if you will. So, if you receive Bishop C.H. Mason in a reading, consider the following. Is conformity always good or bad? The nail that sticks out gets hammered down. So that's definitely speaking on not just thinking out the box, but kind of observing the bigger picture, if you will. Observing the bigger picture. Because it's not always going to be just one-sided to things. We need to learn to observe the bigger picture. So go deeper and explore further. I just said that. Observe the bigger picture. And then, but what's the very next thing that this says? Go deeper and explore further. All right. Do you see the value in your cultural heritage? What was I just speaking on? Us not working with our ancestors. And it's repetitive. It just keeps coming right back. Right back. Set up those altars. You know, even if all you have is a glass of water. You know, and you're like, I love you, ancestors. Thank you so much for your many sacrifices. Here's some water. hey, do that. And I guarantee you're going to start hearing from your ancestors. If you have a desire in life, like if you have dreams and goals and ambitions, and you know the dreams, goals, and ambitions, but you're not sure how to be successful at it, start working with your ancestors. And watch the doors that will open. Watch the things that will start to come to you. It's amazing. It's amazing. So, is what is considered orthodox or the proper way to do things actually orthodox or the proper way to your community? We were just speaking on that. I just said that, like, taught the wrong thing, worshiping the wrong being instead of honoring our ancestors, instead of honoring our Orishas. You know, Black is King, that was some deep shit. Like, that was some deep shit. That's the deepest shit that I've seen Beyonce put out, man. You know, we don't honor our ancestors, man. Everybody else honors their ancestors and they're successful as hell. But then they feed us this bullshit-ass religion that's false and never gonna build us up to where we need to be, man. You know, it's never gonna build us up to where we need to be. So, it might be your best interest to follow the rules at this time. So I don't know if it's something that you're kind of debating on. But if it's saying follow the rules at this time, it's something that you're debating on that may not be ethical, if you will, for lack of a better term. Oh, that's right. Love, love. That is what's up. I'm so glad you got your altar. Like, it's awesome that so many of our people are waking up, man. It's awesome. I love it. I love it. And guess what, Miss Robin? Now that I actually did a reading for you, our altars are connected. Like, our ancestors could actually communicate with each other now. And if we start doing this with each other, like, with not just you and I, but, like, if more of our people start setting up their altars, do you know the power that we're going to bring to this world? Do you know, like, it's... Oh man, I'm so blissed and blissful, Miss Robin, that you have an altar. I'm so blissed and blissful that you are waking up. It gives me hope because our people are asleep, man. We are asleep. We are sleep, 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 sleep. Why do you think they make these zombie movies? Why do you think they make these zombie movies? Like, because they're making fun of us, like straight up. Like, they're making fun of us. So, everyone is a disciple of something, but true disciple is, sorry, everyone is a disciple of something, but true discipline is rare. Are you sure you understand the fine print? Join us, ancestors. Ancestors moving. It's always verified. So, could it be that what is expected of you is good for you? Be on time for the ritual. It's something that they've been telling you to do that you're hesitating on. It's something your ancestors have been telling you to do that you're hesitating on. Go for it. Go for it. Don't stop doubting yourself. That's what I really feel. Like, you're your biggest critic. You're your biggest enemy. Self-doubt. Like, you, oh my goodness, girl, if you only knew, like, if you could literally see your spirit, you would be like a phoenix that's, like, just this glowing flame of blue around you. Like, stop doubting yourself. Stop doubting yourself, man. They on your head. Ancestors don't play. They on your head. Stop doubting yourself. Get back in line. You had, it's like, confidence, like, you don't want to come off as arrogant. That's what I really feel. You don't want to come off as arrogant. Don't worry about that. You're powerful. You're very powerful. And you are very, very loving soul. So don't ever worry about, like, you're coming off as arrogant. You know, speak your mind. I'm getting that as well. Like, you need to speak up in a situation. You know, not be disrespectful or derogatory, But it's a very, it's a situation that you need to speak up in. And the ancestors are going to guide your words on how to handle this situation. So teamwork makes the dream work. And Simon says, follow the leader. So speak your mind. That's just verifying what I just said. Speak your mind. You know, speak your mind. So again, that's Bishop C. Mason. And so now we're going to actually get into the Ace of Knives. And again, I'm not sure the time limit allotment on these videos. So for any reason this video gets cut off, I will start an immediate another one. So just keep your eye out for that. But the next one will be, again, Ace of Knives. So Ace of Knives, it's time to start cutting bullshit out of your life. Yeah, I'm getting that a lot too. Like, you know, it's time to start cutting those toxic people out of your life. Not just people, but toxic thoughts, you know, because the most toxic thing in your life is this. Believe it or not, you get this under control, boy. Woo, it's a wrap. It's a wrap. It's no stopping, you know. Don't rock it, no stopping. Don't rock it, no stop. Alrighty, and so for the Ace of Knives, meaning positive, facing fears. Just said, don't be scared to say what you need to say in a positive way. So facing fears, logic, triumph over adversity, objectivity, intellectuals, mind power, breakthroughs, getting to the point, clarity. I just said that. A moment of silence for our ancestors. I just said that. Clarity. Clarity. You need more clarity. You need to not be scared to voice your opinion. You know, and not even scared, because I don't get the scared energy from you. You don't give a fuck. Okay, you're gonna say what you feel, but it's a situation that you are trying to kind of walk delicate on, and fuck that. You don't need to walk delicate. You need to say what you need to say, and I feel that very strongly. You really do. You need to say what you need to say. Say what you need to say. Alrighty, and so. Seeing through illusions, analysts, quick-witted people, justice, surgery, critical thinkers, authority, calling it as you see it. What did I just say to you, Miss Robin? Did I not just say what you need to say? And then this turns around and says, I'm going to try to show you, see if you can see that. Calling it as you see it. I don't know if you can see that, but calling it as you see it, say what you need to say. It's just literally verbatim what I said right there. So, inability to concentrate. Clarity. That goes back to clarity. Domineering people, bullies, memory loss. Say what you need to say. That's going right back to that. Say what you need to say. Getting cursed out, problems with the law, getting cut off, lack of ideas, and stupid people. Say what you need to say to get them stupid-ass people out your life. Because it's so many powerful beings that are being held back by other individuals, you know? And it's terrible. It's not a good look. It's not a good feeling, you know, at all. Okay, Miss Robin, so last but not least, we have the Nine of Sticks. You see, she got her peace in her peace, you know? Start getting into that Bible for what the real nitty-gritty is, what you're really supposed to be using it for that work, for that magic, you know? And, you know, it's like saying be peaceful. But if need be, you know, and you got a cap of my mind, and that's what it is. And I'm talking about like on a spiritual level, you know, like we need to start learning how to defend ourselves on the astral plane. because we're under so many spiritual attacks, and we'll be like, why is my, oh, I'm so much pain, and I haven't even hurt myself. You know, it's spiritual attacks, man. Better start learning to protect ourselves, and that altar is the first step to getting it together on that. Definitely. So, again, we have the Nine of Sticks. Let me get this pulled up for you, Miss Robin. So, the Nine of Sticks. Peace and still, peace and still, peace be still. The Medea figure. The Medea figure. You definitely have a granny around you. Grammy, you have a lot of people around you. A lot of people. And I feel like it was, in the last about 4 years, I feel like it's three major deaths in your life. I'm getting three. And they, I feel like almost they were like back to back because I see stair steps. I see two were like literally back to back, and the third one was a little bit further away. But they're definitely with you. They're with you, like, woo, 100%. So again, we have the Nine of Sticks. Positive, defending yourself, a test of faith, perseverance, being prepared to fight to the death. Willpower, resilience, guarding your boundaries, and an attitude of would rather do than die. That goes back to what I said. Say what you need to say. Say what you need to say in this situation. You know, I feel like it's somebody that you have a lot of respect for, a very high amount of respect for, but it's like they keep crossing lines they shouldn't. You know, and anybody could only take so much. So regardless of how much respect you have for this person, damn that. Say what you need to say. And that's straight from your ancestors. They're like, say what you need to say, and it keeps repeating. It keeps repeating. Say what you need to say. It's a situation where you have so much respect for this person and so much love for this person, but they keep crossing boundaries that they should not cross. So I hope this resonates with you. I hope that makes sense. Say what you need to say and set boundaries for yourself. Set boundaries. I don't give a damn who it is. Set boundaries for yourself. And that I'm just, you know, it, that blunt as I could possibly be. And I hope that this resonated with you. I hope that you're understanding where the ancestors are coming from. As far as letting you know, say what you need to say, you know, immediately. You need to do that ASAP. You really do. Because that's going to start breaking some generational curses and getting you in the right direction to where you need to go with your ancestors. Definitely. That's a definite factor. And so, like I said, I hope, Miss Robin, I hope that resonated with you. And I will try to save this video if you guys wanted to watch it back. I'll post it on my YouTube as well. So if you could like and subscribe, that would be awesome. I don't really do this that often, but I am going to try to get into it more and incorporate it. You know, just working every day, you really don't have time. But I really, like I said at the beginning, do what you love. I love this. This is what I love. This is what I would love to get paid for. You know what I mean? For helping. Oh, no problem, Miss Robin. No problem. Yeah, you do have a lot of people around you, too. A lot of people. Because of your light, it seems that I really get an energy that sometimes a lot of dark entities try to call come around you. So I'm going to tell you my little secret. This is something that my ancestors showed me. Whenever you feel a dark entity, if you close your eyes and your mind's eye, you're going to see it. You can see exactly what it looks like. So what I want you to do is picture that entity being wrapped in hot lava and burning into cinder and ashes. And I guarantee it works every time. I guarantee. I just actually did it not too long. I had to do it not too long ago because something was fucking with one of our friend's daughter, and I don't play that shit. at all. Don't fuck with no kids, man. Excuse my French people, but I don't play with when it comes to the kids. And yeah, so I did what I had to do. But I feel that it's because of your light and because of your third eye opening, it's going to try to attract some of the not so good entities. So even if you don't picture yourself wrapping them in lava and burning them into ashes, you could picture, like, just create a weapon in your head. You know, a weapon. So that way you could kind of, whenever you feel something that's not right around you, and like say if you're in a great mood and you're upbeat and you're happy and you're walking in love, and all of a sudden you just get angry as hell for no reason, or very sad and depressed, like just want to cry, that's not your energy. That's a negative energy trying to feed off of your energy. And I feel very strongly that your ancestors are going to give you a spiritual weapon to use. It's a weapon that you could create, because that's my weapon that honestly Papa Legba assisted me with. Like, you know, you could burn these motherfuckers up, you know, if you want to, you know. But I really feel strongly that you really need to start protecting yourself spiritually. You could get you again some copal. It's spelled copal, C-O-P-A-L. They actually have incense as well. That's great protection. Florida water. I don't know if you caught the video from the beginning, but Florida water, you probably already know about that. But also, you can put it in a bottle. A spray bottle. Good little spray bottle. Spray it around your house. Agua de Ruda. You could order that online at Amazon. It's spelled A-G-U-A D-E-R-U-D-A. So, Agua de Ruda. If you guys want to write that down, this is some powerful shit right here. Definitely protection. You could also put this in a spray bottle as well and kind of spray it around your house. Copal, you could actually put a rug by the front of your door and put it under your rug. And also, depending on how thick the top of your door is, you could also put it across the top of your door. But it's copal. This is actually black copal. They have white copal, black copal, and it's a mineral. It's a mineral. Alrighty. Yes, definitely, definitely. So, protect yourself. Protect yourself. Message me, Ms. Robin, because we have a lot more to talk about outside of this, because it's a lot of things your ancestors want to say to you that they know that you won't want to be said publicly. So just instant message me if you would like. So, yeah, that's all I got to say. You are powerful as hell. You're powerful. It was meant for me to do this reading tonight. It really was. It really was. And so, Mr., just one moment here. I'm acting like I'm on my dang old Mac looking for my mouse. I know I'm tired. So we have a Mr. Marlon Brown. Are you still here, Mr. Brown? Oh, no problem, Ms. Robin. Please, please hit me up. Hit me up on Messenger. I have some things we need to talk about outside of this, so people aren't, you know, like, because, your ancestors have a lot to say. They really do. They really do. But you are very powerful. You are very powerful. Very, very powerful. Yeah. And it's ironic because we were, like, raised together going to raggedy-ass Ganesha High, running track. I remember when Vinny accidentally caught his leg on the dang on hurdle and scraped his whole chest up and his face. I'll never forget that. But yeah, we me and Miss Robin go back. Mr. Ryan, her brother, still sings his ass off to this day. But yeah, we go back and it's just really truly a blessing to see someone that is connected with the ancestors. Because the way most of us were raised, we were raised in church and we were taught that, you know, this is wrong and this and that and the other. Oh, no problem, Ms. Robin. Thank you. Thank you. Ashe, peace and blessings. Definitely. So we're going to go on and get to Mr. Marlon Brown. I know it's late. I usually would be knocked out by now, but like I said, when spirit moves, spirit moves. Okay, so Mr. Brown, we have Copal for your first pile. We have High John Root for pile number two. And we have Papa Legba's Key for pile number three. So you could go on and focus on your question. You do not have to say the question out loud, but focus on your question. And once you have the question in mind, you could go on and put in 1111. And once you put in 1111, you could go on and tell me if you want pile number one with the Copal, pile number two with the High John Root, or pile number three with Papa Legba's Key. Awesome, got the 1111. By the way, that means doors opening. So if you see a lot of 1111s, that means doors are opening. All right, so you selected the Copal. Again, this is a great mineral for protection. Again, you could actually purchase the incense. I get it at the local smoke shop. So, you know, depending on where you're located, it's amazing. It works very well, very well. So do you also have your question at hand there, Mr. Brown? Oh, yeah, that's definitely, see, this reading, I guarantee, like, this reading was actually Papa Legba. He been telling me all day that he wanted me to do this reading, and I'm not gonna lie, I was tired, but I was like, you know what, it's a reason for this. And so 444 is, because as you know, if you're familiar with Papa Legba, of course, he is the gatekeeper of the crossroads, and at the crossroad, there's four corners. So that just lets me know it's not a coincidence. But 1111 means doors opening, and 444 means you're on the right path. It's letting you know that you're on the right path. You may have to go through a lot, but you're on the right path. So the very first card that we have for you is going to be the Garden. The Garden. Renewal. Refreshing. That's what the garden is, okay? Renewal. What is a garden? You grow fruits, you grow vegetables for nourishment. So it's time for renewal. And it's like I'm just getting a lot of so much self-doubt nowadays. Like, we're such beautiful, magnificent creatures and we doubt ourselves. You know? We doubt ourselves. Self-doubt needs to, cuz you, Like I said, this reading, I feel that the people that were attracted to this reading are spiritual warriors that are trying to find their correct connection on the path. Do you already have your ancestor altar set up, Mr. Marlon? If not, you definitely need to get that set up, and I could give you the steps, you know, for getting it set up. Yeah, because you're waking up spiritually. That's why you're going through a lot, because you're waking up spiritually. So your ancestors are definitely around you, and they've been wanting to work with you, and you've been seeing a lot of strange things. That's why your ancestors want to work with you. So the first thing you need to do is for your ancestor water, altar water. So bottled water, I always use bottled water personally. A nice little glass, and then you know the tall glass candles that they usually have, like if God forbid somebody passes away, they'll have them like at the scene. So you wanna get you a tall glass candle. I use white. You can actually ask your ancestors what color they would prefer. The very key ingredient you want to make sure to state out loud, if you want to write this down, I'll give you a minute to write this down, but this is very important about setting up your ancestor altar, because not every ancestor has good intentions at heart for us. So you want to say, as you're setting up your ancestor altar, I thank you that the ancestors that come to me will be the ancestors that have good intentions at heart for me and my best benefit at heart, and the best benefit for those around me at heart as well. You know, so you want to be very specific about it, because there's a lot of trickster spirits out there. Not all, like I said, not all our ancestors have good intentions at heart. You might have that ancestor that was a serial killer. You might have that ancestor that was a rapist. You know what I mean? You do not want to feed them off of your altar. You don't want the energy around you. So that's the key ingredient, is please be careful while setting up your altars that you are making sure to verbalize to only deal with those that care about you, that have love in their heart, that are enlightened beings, that care about the betterment of humanity. Okay? Now, when it comes to time, if you're being under spiritual attack, and you do got to sometimes call on those ancestors that may have been gangbangers, that may have didn't play and will light a nigga up, okay? You may have to call on them at times. But far as just walking on a daily basis, you want to make sure that you're careful about who you allow to your altar. It's the same as, you're not going to just allow anybody into your house, right? Physically. So you kind of got to guard yourself spiritually as well. You got to guard yourself spiritually as well. Ancestors moving, ancestors moving. Woo, man. This is powerful tonight. But so again, the garden is the card that we pulled, the very first card that you pulled. So let me actually get the garden pulled up for you. That is actually a dominant card, by the way. It's one of the high arcane cards. So one moment here. Thank you so much for you guys' patience. I know it is late as hell. I haven't been up this late in a long ass time. But it's like, I felt very strongly that it was a message that, you know, needed to be brought across. So I'm looking for that garden card right now. Just one moment here. Garden card hiding. There we go. As soon as I said it, it popped up. All right. So for the garden card, the world. Okay. So that means there's some things coming your way. I could tell you that right now before I even read it. It's some, I don't know if it's financial, but it's something that you've been waiting on that has been seeming to take forever, and it's going to open. It's going like that. That's what I feel. It's something that you've been waiting on, and the answer is yes. I almost feel like it's a yes or no question, and the answer is yes. So, meaning, when the garden appears in a reading, it's letting you know that you've successfully taken care of business. What did I just say? You've successfully taken care of business, and it's time to reap all the goodness that you've sown. Count your blessings. If your query relates to gossip or rumors, the garden could be trying to tell you to mind your own business. Shit's about to get real. I told you, these cards don't play. They're very blunt. So it's something that, and I almost feel like it's not that you're getting involved in it. It's somebody's bringing you bullshit. You know, I really feel that. Like, it's somebody that's bringing you some bullshit, and you're fucking tired of that shit. You're tired of it. Like, every time they come around, it's just a bunch of bullshit. Cut them loose. You know, whenever you're up and up, it's like this person has a tendency to come around and bring you down, or try to bring you down, because you're a very strong person at keeping your emotions up. But cut them whenever you see their ass coming. Let them know straightforward. Look, if you don't have something positive to say, I don't want to hear that shit no more. Because they're bringing you down. And it's like whenever you're feeling your energy is up or whenever you're trying to make a positive move, it seems like they always come into the picture out of nowhere. That's the perfect... See, this is just verification from the ancestors. But, yeah, just in general. Not even in general, like, period. Not just... It's like... And I feel that. It's like... You seem to be approached by a lot of negativity. And it's mostly when your energy is up and you're happy and you're in that great mode. And then it's like out of nowhere. Just like, what the hell are you fucking with me for? Like, why? Why me? You need to protect yourself. Once you get that ancestor altar up, that's going to help a lot. Because then you'll have that direct connection with your ancestors. But again, water, Florida water... Get your Florida water. I actually get mine from Walmart. You could actually order it online. Get it in a spray bottle. That way you can spray it around your house, on your rugs, beds, furniture, clothes in the closet. That helps. But get your ancestor altar up. I really feel that. Like, I really feel... Get your ancestor altar up. I don't care if you find one little corner of your house... And you put your little candle, you put your little water, fruit, bananas, apples, oranges, peaches, any fresh fruit. You could put on a nice little plate, you know, and water, a nice glass of water. And I thank you, ancestors, for working with me. I thank you, ancestors, for protecting me. I thank you that only ancestors and beings of a higher light that have the good of humanity in their heart will be able to come with me and assist me. And watch how your life changes. Watch, just watch. I'm speaking like from experience. Do not take my word for anything. Don't believe shit I say. Look for it. Look it up for yourself. Try it for yourself. And watch. Just watch how it works out for you. Alrighty. So the garden. So if your query relates to gossip or rumors, the garden could be trying to tell you to mind your business. It's reminding you of how much better the world would be if everyone focused on their own affairs instead of being concerned about others. Did you see the reading that I just did before this? It's like it's leading right into each other. I just said that's the problem with society is everybody's worrying about everybody else instead of worrying about their own damn self. And if they put the same energy into their self as they put into gossiping, the world will be a much better place. It'll be a much better place. So I'm feeling like almost like not only cutting off the negativity around you, but kind of being a light in a dark situation. Like start pointing out the positives in people's life when they're pointing out the negatives. You know, because I feel like that's something that you really love to do. You really love to like try to help people, like lift them up. Whenever you see somebody's going through something, you always try to, even if it's something, somebody you really don't know, like if you see they're kind of going through a dark time, even if you just smile and say, you know, I hope it gets better for you, always try to encourage people. So these negative ass entities are trying to stop that shine. They're trying to stop that shine. Don't let them. Don't let them. Keep spreading that light. You keep spreading that love. You keep spreading that smile. You love to cook. And I feel like, I don't know if you were trying to get into a business cooking for people or something along the lines of that, but are almost, I don't know, do you actually like help homeless people? Like whenever you can, like you try to give them food or you always, I don't know why cooking for the homeless, that really comes to me very strong. Cooking for the homeless. Like, you need to start feeding the homeless. I feel like it's a lot of homeless people for some reason that you come into contact with. It's like they're attracted to you for some reason. And you'll have the most mundane conversations with them. But I feel like, start feeding the homeless. Start feeding the homeless. Start. I don't care if you only have a penny and you give that to them. Start. I really feel that very strongly. I don't believe that's a coincidence, because that just came to me too strong. Way too strong. So, if you receive the garden in the reading, consider the following. In what ways do you heal the world? What were we just talking about, Mr. Brown? What did I just say about helping the homeless? And it literally turns around and says, in what ways do you heal the world? Seriously, consider the benefits of working there or joining that club. What was I just saying? The solution has arrived. There is nothing more to seek. And we just saw the first card. You think you freaked out now? Wait till we get to these other two cards. The solution has arrived. There is nothing more to seek. What makes you feel safe and grounded and whole? We were just speaking on that. What makes you happy? Don't wait for anyone else to have a pleasurable experience. You got to create your own happiness. You have to create your own happiness. Stop and smell the roses. Slow down. Whenever you see that, slow down. Slow down. Take your time. Be careful in the up and coming weeks. Slow down. Watch your surroundings. I feel that very strongly. You made it, now enjoy it. You do so much for everybody else and you're not taking the time to enjoy you. Slow down. That just verified what I just said about slow down. You made it, now enjoy it. Kick your feet up. Stop doubting yourself. Stop letting other people tell you what you can and cannot do and why you won't be successful because they weren't successful. Success is in your being. Success is in your melanin. Success is in your DNA. And you have so much to bring to this world. So stop it. Cut off these negative ass energies, man. Cut them assholes off. They're not worth it. And I feel like it's not just one. It's more than one. So we're done with the garden card. So the next card is going to be the Four of Baskets. With the stubborn ass sitting there rolling her little eyes and her arms crossed. Stop being stubborn. You have so many options and opportunities, but I feel like you have a tendency to judge books by their cover. Stop. Stop. There's people of various ethnicities that can actually help you get to where you need to be. Stop. And like I said, that's the only thing I can do is be very straightforward and blunt. When your ancestors come through, they come through. Stop being stubborn. Stop. You have so many opportunities and you're being very stubborn about them, about how you want the opportunity to come through. It's not always going to be in the way that you think. It might be opportunities that come through, but because of your stubbornness, you're missing opportunities. Major blessings in your life. Stop being stubborn. It's not always going to be one way. It's always going to be open ways on the highway. And once you realize that you don't always have to go to the left, you don't always have to go to the right. You might go straight ahead. And once you realize that, things are going to take off for you. Things are going to take off for you. Be more open-minded. Be more open-minded. Stop being stubborn. The Four of Baskets. So let's go on and get that Four of Baskets pulled up for you here. Just one moment. Let's see what the Four of Baskets has to say for you. Ha. So. A young woman is being offered just one more basket after rudely rejecting the other three. How many baskets does that make? One more basket after rudely rejecting three. Four. There goes your four. Okay? The Four of Baskets. There goes your four again. Okay? There's no coincidence here. I just said that you need to be more open-minded as to the opportunities that are coming your way. And as it clearly says, a young woman is being offered just one more basket after rudely rejecting the other three. And that four keeps, see, the four popping up right in your reading. Right in your reading. Right along your reading. Right away. Four baskets. So, revitalization, meditation, introspection, and the end of stagnation. Opening your mind and thinking outside the box, that's what that's going to create. The end of stagnation. Because there's been so many opportunities that have approached you, but because of the bullshit that you've been through, you have a tendency to have a closed mind. You need to open your mind. Because there's major opportunities coming your way, but you have to get out of that mind state of judging the book by its cover. And I feel that so strongly. So strongly. And so that's the four of baskets again. Positive, revelation, meditation, introspection. That's going inward. That's going within. You know, and finding that power within you. And you're going to be successful. You're going to be successful in your endeavors. I really feel that. It's going to be some trials and tribulations there, but you're going to be successful in your endeavors. But you have to be more open-minded. Because there's people that are willing to help and assist you, but you have to be more open-minded. You can't be so closed-minded about the outer appearance. And I'm getting that very strongly. And whenever it's repetitious, it's letting you know something very powerful there. And again, that was the four of baskets, okay? Along with the very first one, which was the garden. So last but not least, we actually have the eight of sticks. Hopefully you can see it. That's the eight of sticks. Okay. So let's get the eight of sticks pulled up for you here. Some powerful, powerful things going on tonight. Some powerful, powerful things. Okay, there we go. So again, the eight of sticks. And this resembles what I was saying earlier about negative ass people. You know, negative ass people, man. And it's time to cut them out. And you already said that, of course, that one of them, like, you know that you're done with. But I feel like it's more than one. And it's, like, really, really hard when it's, like, people, like, say, mom or granny or a little sis or a little brother. But, like, regardless, like, if they're negative and toxic, man, it's, you know, like, it's time to do what you gotta do, like, for real. And it's like, I'm speaking to myself as well. I'm definitely speaking to myself as well. So for the eight of sticks, the plant for the eight of sticks is the poplar. The image, a hoodoo woman is peeling wood from a tree just struck by lightning. It is believed that lightning struck wood amplifies the potency of any working. What have I been saying? You need to set up an altar. You need to set up an altar. So I don't know if you have a pen handy, but again, water. If you possibly have like a nice little wine glass or something like that, that's what I use. If you don't, that's fine. It's where your heart is. So water, fresh water, fruit. If you have any herbs like rosemary or thyme, cayenne pepper, I'll put that on my altar sometimes on a plate with honey. But you know, just speak with your ancestors, because a lot of times your ancestors may want something really simple, you know, and you never know. I had an ancestor ask me for hot Cheetos. Go figure, you know, but it just be aware, pay attention, And by setting up your altar, that actually connects you much more strongly to your ancestors, so you'll hear them more clear, you know? So it doesn't have to be perfect. It doesn't have to be fancy. Don't be scared. Just set it up, you know? In your heart, you'll know, because your ancestors have been walking with you all your life. Those protectors that they call angels that you speak of, that's your ancestors. So they know. So even if you don't have a cup, you could literally you could get a fresh bottle of water and just say, ancestors, I love you. Here you go. You know, I'm sorry. This is all I got is this water, but I want to give this to you. And if you do put it in a glass, I guarantee you'll know when your ancestors are around, because you're going to start seeing bubbles form around that water glass, or you're going to literally wake up and see that that water has been drunk. Because I literally filled my water glass up yesterday. I just gave my libations and filled it back up for my ancestors. And it's already like this much water gone already the next day. So it's just a matter of doing it. You could actually get your Florida water and just set it on the altar. You know, set it on the altar. And every morning, just make it a habit of going and taking your Florida water and put it on your third eye. You can put it on your neck, rub it on your hands, rub it over your heart. I always put it over my heart. It's protection. You can get your Florida water soap. You can get that online through Amazon. Florida water barred soap. Something simple as that to watch. Start doing your spiritual bath. Start doing your spiritual cleansing. And, you know... there is a brother by the brother, his name is Brother Yosef, and he's on YouTube. I believe it's Y-O-S-E-F, but Yosef, you can look him up, and just, you know, start doing research, start doing spiritual research, not even on a religious level, you know, start doing spiritual research. But Brother Yosef, I mean, he'll get you on that right path. You know, he'll get you on that right path. But you can start doing research, like look up, Orishas. You could look up, like Papa Legba, Mama Oya. You know what I mean? Ogun, Oshun. You know, start getting into the Haitian Orishas. Definitely Papa Legba. Like, if you really want to work with your ancestors, that's somebody that I feel... On this reading, I feel that Papa Legba was reaching out to whoever got this reading today very strongly. And once you start working with him, he's going to actually open the gates for you to work with your ancestors. Get your ancestor money. And you want to write the name of your loved ones that passed away, your ancestors. If you don't know their names, you could say, I give this in honor of my bloodline and my ancestors with love and light. May you accept this on your astral plane. So that's another thing. May you accept this on your astral plane, you know, and even if, say, if you don't have ancestor money, incense, you know what I mean? Like, all I have is this incense. I love y'all, because with the times, I understand that not everybody's going to have everything all fancy, but ancestors don't give a shit about that. Just even if you don't have a candle, even if you don't have water, you could go into the corner and say, ancestors, I love you. I don't have nothing, but I just give you my love and my honor and my admiration. And I thank you for the many sacrifices. I thank you for those of you that were transported as slaves and did not make it. I thank you for those of you that gave your life for us to be free and to be where we are today. And that is enough. And then whenever you're able to get your water, whenever you're able to, you know, whatever else you need, you know, to get to your ancestors, if you feel in your heart, like if you, and something else, like my grandmother let me know that she wanted coffee. My grandmother passed away several years ago. And whenever we go in the refrigerator, the dang on coffee creamer will fall and spill all over the floor, no matter what. We could put the coffee creamer in the back of the refrigerator. The moment we open that refrigerator, the coffee creamer is spilling out. And I realized in my heart and soul, like, my granny wants coffee. Do you know, after I gave my granny that coffee on that altar, that never happened again? And then it was a couple weeks after that, I had a dream that coffee creamer spilled. And my granny came and was like, can I get some coffee, please? So once you start working with your ancestors, they're going to come to you and let you know. They'll let you know that, you know, thank you in your dreams. I've had ancestors come to me, like, and let me know, definitely, thank you so much. I really appreciate you. But it's just a matter of taking those first steps and not giving a shit what nobody thinks. That's the hardest thing as in Gleason people. Our people are so quick to be like, oh, that's the devil. That's satanic. Not at all. Not at all. They want us to believe that because that's where our power is. And they use our shit against us. But that's a whole nother video. All right, so the Eight of Sticks again. So, rapid progress, forward movement, communication, finding a resolution, excitement, whirlwind, romance is gaining momentum, receiving a critical message, eye-opening experience, being in alignment, ending of delays, travel by air, a successful journey. You had a yes or no. I feel like you had a yes or no question, but it was kind of like still other lingering things there. Yes. Clearly it's yes. Bottom line. And I said that from the beginning. Your answer is yes. Now you're going to have to do some work on your end, but it's yes. It's going to happen for you. And you just have to push and pursue and not allow these negative ass people to deter you from your shine. Because you have a bright ass shine and it's so many haters, man. Just so many haters that don't want to see you shine. I feel that you were raised very religious, so your main quarrel with the whole situation is like what your family would think, or don't worry about that shit. Don't worry about it. Because once you start walking with your ancestors and you see the outcome, you could care less about what anybody thinks, you know. But I truly, really hope this reading resonated with you. I'm so blissful and blessed that I was able to give you a reading today. Did you have any other general questions pertaining to your reading today? Or tonight, should I say, this early morning? You still there, Mr. Brown? I see one person there. Is that you, Mr. Brown? I think it's moving a little bit slow, so I'm not sure if you responded yet. Yes, sir. So I hope that resonated with you. Did you have any questions, you know, on the reading where it wasn't very clear for you? And what was your question? Oh, no problem, no problem. Yeah, definitely, definitely. That's fine. Because a lot of times the ancestors have a lot to say, but it's like they know our hearts and our soul. So certain things that, you know, we may not want to talk about in public. So I get just what you're saying. But that's fine. You could definitely message me. Follow me at me as a friend if we're not already friends. I'm going to repost this video as well. So if you want to, you know, watch over it again, and maybe if you have any other questions, that's fine as well. And, you know, I'll try to do more readings as well, because I really, like I said, I really love doing this. I'm greatly appreciative that I could give you a reading. And like I said, I hope it was on point for you. If you have any questions that you could think of pertaining to your reading, or, you know, anything that comes to you, you can definitely go on and hit me up and I'll be more than happy to speak with you. And I'll try to get back to you in a timely manner. But like I said, I really enjoy this. I thank you so much, Mr. Brown. And what I'll do if in the future when I have more readings, I'll definitely go on and tag you in that if you would like. Oh, no problem. And I would like to say to you, Ashe, have a blissful day. And on behalf of your ancestors, set that altar up. Set it 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 up. Because they'll remind you now. Now that they already talked to you through me and they know that you're aware, oh, they're going to be reminding you. I promise you. Because I get the stubborn energy off of you. So you might not set it up like right away, but you do have good intentions about it. But watch, you're going to be like taking a shower or doing something and you're going to feel, you going to set that altar up yet? You're going to be like, okay, I'm going to get it. I'm going to get it. I'm going to get it. And then next thing you know, you're going to be dozing off to sleep and you're going to wake wide awake. So you going to get that altar yet? That's how it was with me. And once you finally set it up, man, doors are going to open. Doors are going to open. If you have any questions along the way about setting it up, or if you have any ideas about something that you want to add to your altar and you're not sure, you can definitely hit me up about that. That's no problem. Just any questions in general. You know anybody else that may have questions in general? It's no charge or anything like that. I do this out of love, like, period. Like I said, I love what I do. So any questions you have, just in general, if you're kind of going through it and you need encouraging words, anything like that, you know, just anything in general, I'll be right here for you. So, you know, once we do a reading, like I said, it's like that's a connection. It's a connection there. And you have mad ancestors around you. You have... I don't know why I feel like it's a child around you that passed away. A little girl. Like, very strongly. She's adorable. She has, like, these cute little cheeks. But I don't know... Like, I feel that there's a child, like, clearly a child that passed away around you. I don't know if maybe that child passed away when they were a baby, but now I feel like they're maybe 4 or 5. So there's definitely a child energy around you, if that makes any sense. Like, I really feel that there's a child around you. I do see that I got one more person in there. I was about to get off, but I don't know if you want a little 3-card reading real quick. I could go on and do that for you. If you do, you could go on and, put an 11-11 in there. If not, it's not a daughter. It may actually be a future child. It may be actually a future child, but I strongly feel a little girl's present around you. It's not your daughter. It's not your current daughter. It could actually be a child that will be born to you at a later time. It could be one of your ancestors. But I strongly feel a little girl around you. I almost feel like if something, like sometimes things are out of place. Like, you know where you put something and you'll go to check it and it's not there no more. And then you'll go back and it's there. But you know you just checked and it's not. And you're like, I know I just checked here. It was not there. Yes. Oh, yeah. You got a daughter on the way to you. She's gorgeous too. She is gorgeous and rambunctious. She's gonna be the one to give you a run for your money. I see dimples. Cause the way I see her is she is 5. She's about 5, 4 or 5 while she's coming to me. And she has her little 2 front teeth missing. She has dimples. She has this pretty... I don't know. I feel like she's of mixed ethnicity. Almost like Hispanic and Black. But you got a daughter around you. Sorry to tell you. I hate to be the one to break the news to you. But she's definitely around. She's been kind of doing little things here and there in the household too. Lights flickering, or like to where you're like, I know it's not a ghost around. No, that's your daughter. She's a character too, just like you. Yep, it's a girl. congratulations. Sorry to be the one to tell you. But she's beautiful. She's a beautiful soul. She's an old being, by the way. She's a very old soul. And she chose you for a reason. Very old soul, and she chose you for a reason. And I almost feel like it's not going to be immediately. I don't know why. I don't feel like it's going to be like immediately, but it'd be within the next maybe year or so. And again, I see that there's somebody else there. If you wanted me to do a little 3-card reading for you before I get off, we can do that. I'm normally asleep at this time, but I'm like wide awake. Like the energy is just like, I probably don't look wide awake, but I actually am. Oh, wow. Yeah, so, yeah, it's a girl. Definitely, like, and, like, I could, like, if you could see her, she's beautiful. Like, I could literally, like, feel her in my mind's eye. She has dimples. She's about 5. She's missing her 2 front teeth. And I feel like she has a ponytail going up, and it's, like, curly going down. And she's of, like I said, mixed ethnicity. Yes, Miss Karen. I could do a 3-card reading for you. So just one moment here. Let me actually cleanse the cards, because I did do a couple of reading for some people here. So you got it. You got it. You're ready. She's about to teach you a lot of things, because she's an old soul. She chose you for a reason. Oh, no problem, Miss Elizabeth. I got you. So I'm going to just cleanse the cards real quick with this sage, just due to the fact that I did some readings, but I already put the cards back in the pile. So just give me one moment here to get this cleansed, and then I could go on and do a 3-card reading for you real quick. So what you can actually do is think of a question for me. You don't have to put it on the thread. If you want to, you can, but you don't have to. So just think of a question. It could be a yes or no question. It could be a life question. Just whatever comes to mind. And once you... So just bear with me one moment here. So we're going to do... And then we're going to pull something from the bottom. And then something from the middle. All right, so the way that we're actually doing this, Miss Karen, so the first thing we have here is called copper. It's actually protection. It's like a mineral, if you will. Okay? So this is for pile number 1. All right? And then this right here is called High John, or John the Conqueror root. This is also protection. So this is going to be pile number 2 for you, okay? And then last but not least, we actually have Papa Legba's key, the gate opener that connects you with your ancestors, which is pile number 3. So I just need you to focus on your question. Like I said, you don't have to say the question out loud. Just think about what your question is over and over and over, and for a clear answer. And once you think about that question, you could put 1111 for me. And then once you put 1111, then you could pick pile number 1, the couple, pile number 2, that High John the Conqueror, and pile number 3, the key, Papa Legba's key. So, once you think of the question, again, hit 1111 for me. And then once you hit 1111, then you could go on and put pile number 1, pile number 2, are pile number three. And just let me know when you're ready. It's not a rush. Take your time. Focus on that question. Okay. So pile number three. Papa Leg has been moving all day, man. I think I did about four readings, and out of the four, three picked the key. So that's saying a lot here. Alrighty, so you picked number three. Okay, so for number three, something you're pertaining to finances here. And going against something, or like something's coming against you, that's how you feel. So the first card we actually have is going to be John Horse, okay? And so I've been actually on this video for a while. If for any reason, Miss Elizabeth, this video cuts off, I'll start another one right away and we'll pick up where we left off. So hopefully that doesn't happen, but just in case, okay? And so again, that's John Horse. As you see, that's a warrior. Warriors on the other side watching over you, okay? And so for John Horse, and this is actually a master card, a dominant card out of the arcane, the major arcane. So let me actually get that John Horse pulled up for you. Just bear with me one moment here. Thank you for your patience. So John Horse. There we go. Okay, so with John Horse, the plant is the cypress plant, okay? And so John Horse is seated calmly on his throne. He has a rifle strapped to him. He's clutching his knife in one hand and in the other hand, balled into a tight fist. I was just saying that. You're fighting something. And I don't know why I feel like this is spiritual. This is spiritual. It's something that you're going through majorly, almost to the point where you feel like giving up, but you're too strong and you know you're not. You're not. You're too strong. So you're like, I'm never going to give up. Okay, so when John Horse appears in a reading, you are being advised to take charge of whatever is going on in your life. I just was speaking on that. Just speaking on it. This is not the time for self-doubt or weakness of any kind. For if you indulge in those emotions too long, you are certain to lose more than you can imagine. The odds may be tough. Victory is still achievable. When a card comes up, there is simply no other course of action but to get organized and then charge full steam ahead. So you have to overcome that fear. It's something that you have been thinking about doing. It's something that you've been thinking about doing. And you're kind of fearful about it. Like, if you will be successful, you will. You need to go on and push for that. You really do. So when this card comes up, it's simply no other course of action but to get organized and charge full steam ahead. However, John Horse is also reminding you that even the greatest warriors require support. He is telling you that you may increase your chance of winning by having the right spiritual teachers in your corner. Excuse me. So I feel like it's someone that you are around that is kind of spiritually advanced, and some of the things that they say are too far-fetched for you at the moment, if that makes any sense. But I feel like you need to, like, kind of take their advice. You know, some of the things that this person says are kind of like, like, kind of hanky, if you will. But I feel that overall they would have awesome advice for you. Awesome advice. All right, so if you receive John Horse as a reading, consider the following. Effective leadership requires wise counsel and up-to-date information. So I feel like that's more of a compromise, if you will. Try to find a way to be more compromising with your baby. That's like direct as it can be with that. So are you following the right leaders or elders at this stage in your journey? So again, it goes back to spiritual guidance. Yeah, definitely. Definitely. So you would... Let me try to word this correctly. Stop being closed-minded about spiritual issues. It's not only one way. You need to be more open-minded. And your baby's very psychic. I feel like almost like she sees spirits. I really feel that very strongly, that she sees spirits. You may see her kind of react to things in a certain manner. But your baby is very, very psychic, very, very open spiritually. She's very gifted, if you will. So, what does the lineage mean to you? Do you know yours? Working with ancestors, that has been the topic of the day, is we need to start working with our ancestors. Because they're our protectors, they watch over us. She seems to sense, though. Oh, that's because she's been here before. So that's what the reason is for that. She's definitely been here before. In her last life, actually, believe it or not, I feel like she was a male in her last life, not a girl. I feel she was a boy in her last life. So she may have a lot of masculine characteristics, if you will. If that makes any sense. She likes to do a lot of boy stuff. Like, she would prefer to play with boy toys if she could, as opposed to Barbies. She would rather play with, like, a truck or a Hot Wheel or, you know, something like that. Okay, I see what you're saying. Probably Lushless from Tomboy. Definitely. Yeah, she's been here before. Her last life was a male. But she's highly psychic intuitive, and she's very, 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 very intuitive. Very intuitive. Like, if you see your baby's acting a certain way around someone, pay attention. Pay attention. I don't care how damn nice they seem. Pay attention, because she knows spirits and she can see through people. You know, and I feel like, you know, it's someone trying to play you around you. Like, I feel it's somebody playing games around you. That's not sincere. And she knows. She knows, because she acts very weird around them. And they seem like they seem so special and nice and kind. They're full of shit. And I feel like you know who I'm talking about. So just be careful. It is a guy. Be very careful around him. So the next one we have is going to be the Ten of Coins. Ten of Coins. As you see, it's a happy family there. They're sitting around, looks like they're having dinner or some type of celebration. So it's about to be some sort of celebration soon for you. I don't know. I almost feel like you were thinking about going back to school, or I don't know if you started back to school already. But I feel like that you're going to be successful. Oh, wow. Yeah, so you know what? You could actually start an altar for your granny, like working with your ancestors, because she's definitely watching over you. Yeah, you're going to be successful in your schooling. That's what I feel. Like, you've been doubting yourself or, like, wondering, you know, if you could hang because of the shit that you've been going through. But I feel like you're going to be successful at your schooling. I really do. You're going to do very good at it. So let's get the Ten of Coins for you here. Just one moment. A lot of cards here. Sorry about that. And I just got this deck not too long ago, so I'm kind of still learning my way through it. So, alrighty. So it is the Ten of Coins. Alright, alright. So, positive, strong family ties, supportive relatives, ancestors, inherit. What did I just say? Didn't I just not say that you need to work with your ancestors? And then the very next card, just verify what I said. I just said you need to start working with your ancestors. So, inheritance, old money, proud legacies, trust funds, family gatherings, financial stability, plenty, respecting family traditions, business success, and unexpected windfalls. Didn't I say that? That's some major financial shifts coming your way for the positive. That just verified. Just verified it. So that was a short read on this one. Oh, that's awesome. Because you could actually start your altar with that. Like, you could put the Buddha there. Like, you could literally take, like, a little regular little table. And if you have a picture of your grandma, you know, I usually put a white, like, blanket or sheet over my altar. You know, you don't necessarily have to do that. You could allow your granny to kind of guide you. But you could, like, just set up a table, put a little nice sheet over it, put some water, put a picture of your granny. And then if she has, like you said, the Buddha, you could put that Buddha statue there for her. And then you could build off of that and just, you know, say, I thank you that my ancestors will come to me that have good intentions at heart for me. You know, and start with that. Just something simple as a nice glass of water, fruit. If your granny liked coffee, make her a nice cup of coffee and say, hey, grandma, come drink with me. You know, if your granny likes bananas, put her a banana on a plate. Granny, come on here. Here you go. I have this banana for you. But that's the step. That's the start, is by setting up the altar, because then you'll start seeing your ancestors are going to start working with you more and guiding you. And you'll start noticing, like, you'll feel in your gut like, oh, okay, I shouldn't go this way. Don't. Once you start waking up, like, your life is going to change drastically. It's going to change drastically. I don't believe that there's a coincidence that you're here right now speaking with me. And I feel like, because that was the main objective of this video, I feel like the ancestors want us to work with them. Your ancestors want you to start working with them. And that's the first step. Just set up a nice little altar. Like I said, I don't know why I feel like your granny liked coffee. I feel like she wants coffee. I really do. Like, it just keeps coffee. Like, I need coffee. Give me some coffee, please. I will try that I dream about her when we visit the grave and the funeral. I saw her. Yeah, and you could also do some ancestor money for her. You could actually order it online. I got mine from Amazon. But you can definitely do some ancestor money. Like, you will write your grandma's name on it and then say, may you accept this on your astral plane. And then you can, like, burn it in, if you have a fireplace or really, like, a type of glass bowl or, like, a metal pan, you could actually do it that way. But I don't know. I feel like you're... yeah, your granny wants some coffee. Like, I feel that so strongly. Like, she wants some coffee. Like she's like, you know, set up some coffee for me. And so the last card we have here is actually going to be the Three of Knives. When it comes to these are usually saying there's certain things that it's time to cut out of your life. Excuse me. So... for the Three of Knives, let's get that pulled up. Just one moment here. Oh, wow. Went right to it the first time. So, a wounded person lies against a bottle tree with broken bottles as a strong dog urinates on their loved one's grave. Triple ouch. The Southern tradition of creating tree and... isn't that ironic that you literally just said that you dream about your granny whenever you go to her grave? And that's really ironic that I just said your granny wants coffee. So that's, yeah, that's very ironic. Triple ouch. The Southern tradition of creating bottle trees is an Africanism form of Congo people who believe that spirits could reside in the bottles. The idea was to capture any negative spirits and allow the sunlight to destroy them at dawn. So I just was speaking on that as well, removing the negativity out of your life. Trapping the negative things that no longer serve you. It's time to, like, not necessarily even people, but, like, certain habits of thought patterns. Oh, wow. I'm sorry to hear that. But, she wants coffee. I'm gonna keep saying it, because she's... oh, man, your grandma is very persistent, like, in what she wants. She wants coffee. She's like, can you please give me some coffee? Since you don't currently have an altar set up yet, you could actually just, like, make some coffee and say, granny, here, this coffee is for you, and, like, set it on the table. And she'll be able to get that energy from the coffee. Yeah, I had that issue with my dad and my mom. So I know exactly what you're going through on that. Definitely. Let me see. Yeah, so definitely. And like I said, just for your ancestor altar, you could literally, you know, have like a little table, a nice little table, like an end table. Or if you have a little corner of your room and you could just like put some water, put some fruit, and then of course like coffee for your granny. And then with the fruit, it lasts a lot longer. So with the fruit, that does work a little bit better because then your ancestors could actually feed off of the energy from that fruit for a lot longer. Oh, yeah. Oh, no, it's okay. It's all a part of the growing process. Like if a lot of times if we didn't go through what we went through, we won't be strong enough to deal with the other things to come in our future. So I'm grateful for the negative in my life as well as for the positive, because then you realize you have... huh? Oh, so your granny had a fake fruit bowl? But yeah, you want to put real fruit. You won't want to put fake fruit because that doesn't have any energy for our ancestors. But yeah, that just lets me know that that is just like... because she's coming through strong. And the main thing she wants is coffee. I don't know why. I feel like, I don't know if she used to drink her coffee black, but I feel like she wants black coffee. Okay, so pain subsiding, resurrection. People who are determined to survive, renewal, optimism, reconciliation, seeking help for emotional problems, learning how to cope, accepting apology only when you're ready, improved health, overcoming depression, healing, and the worst being over. So you went through a very, very dark, dark time recently, very depressed. And it's just letting you know you came through that like a soldier, and the worst part is over. So the worst part is over. So you just have to keep, you know, pressing on. And like I said, ancestors. Oh, please work with your ancestors. Get Granny some coffee as soon as possible. Once you get Granny that coffee, you're going to start seeing immediate changes. Once you start working with your ancestors. Like, and that's what I feel. Because, like, not a lot of people actually responded to this video. And I feel that the people that did, as you did, Miss Elizabeth, it's a reason. Because it's so many powerful beings that don't even realize how powerful you are. And so that's the first step, is working with your ancestors. You could actually look on YouTube, you know, ancestor altars. Yeah, so you're coming up out of that depression now. You're coming up out of that depression. You're very powerful. And he wasn't worth it anyway. You know, he didn't have any good intentions for you at heart. He was a fucking jerk and a jackass. So you're saving face. You know, that's a benefit to you. He did you a favor, you know, to make room for somebody that really cares about you. So that's great that he's no longer in your life. And, you know, I can't imagine what it's like, because I know that, you know, you'll still feel, you know, some type of way towards that person. Like, you still love him. But that he wasn't beneficial to you or your baby by any means. He was very self-centered and just thought about himself. So you're better than that. You're way better than that. And it's much more amazing things that are coming your way. Definitely. Within the next couple months. So, did you have any questions for me? Any, like, direct questions in regards to the reading or general information about the ancestor altar or anything like that? Oh, no problem. No problem. I'm so glad that I was able to actually do that reading for you. Like, I don't believe in coincidence. Like I said, I would normally be asleep by now. And I could see that that someone else was there watching that didn't respond. And I just feel like, you know, I don't know. I just feel that you needed that reading. I really do. And, you know, just in general, like, if you ever have any general questions, you could definitely inbox me. And I'll be more than happy to assist you. Did you have any other questions at all? Thank you. I can relate a lot. Now you say, is my comment coming up on the right part? Is that what you're saying? Like, do I see your comments? Yeah, I could see them. But again, this was out of Hoodoo Tarot. You could actually order that on Amazon. Yeah, I could see your comment. Did you have any other questions for me today? I mean, should I say this evening, tonight, Miss Elizabeth? And I will cleanse the energy one more time from the reading. And all I say, be peaceful, be blissful, and let's walk in love. And you definitely have a very special baby. Your daughter, yeah, she's very connected spiritually, and she can teach you a lot spiritually. You know, just encourage her, and just pay attention, like, because I feel like she really sees things that you can't see. You know, so just, like, pay attention. And that way she could be guided in the right direction with her gift. Because she's a very, very, very gifted person. So I'm sending love and light your way. Peace, healing, and blessings. And again, I thank you so much. I'm so glad I was able to have the opportunity to give you the reading. And you have a very blissful night. And I do thank you so much. And again, Ashe, Ashe to our ancestors. Ashe, Ashe to our Rishas. Ashe, Ashe, Aibobo to Papa Legba. Definitely for opening the doors and continuing to open the doors. And so again, I'm going to post it on YouTube, so please subscribe, please like there, please follow, please friend, please, you know, love and light to everyone. And again, Ashe, peace and blessings, and I'm out.